Hello children, today I am starting here with the topic event in sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction includes three events. First is pre-fertilization, second fertilization, third is post-fertilization. So first pre-fertilization. What is pre-fertilization events? Pre-fertilization events include all the events which occur before fertilization, means before the fusion of male and female gamete. Now pre-fertilization event again divided into two event, gametogenesis and gamete transfer. Here we will take first gametogenesis. Now what is gametogenesis? Gametogenesis is the process of formation of two types of gametes, that is male and female gametes. Gametes are always haploid. This is very important point. You have studied in your previous classes also, gametes are always haploid, and it means they have half number of chromosomes of a fully formed organism. Here you can see with the help of example, these are the gametes. When they fuse, they form the diploid organism. This is the complete organism which consists of 46 number of chromosome. Here gametes, they are consisting of half number of the chromosome. So we can say that gametes, they have half number of chromosomes of fully formed organism. Now come to the next point. Gametes are different in organisms. See here, if we take the example of algae, which is a lower organism, gametes are similar in shapes and size. You can see here, I have shown this with the help of diagram. Gametes of algae are similar in shape and size. That is why they are called isogametes. Here I have given the example of Cladophora, which is a kind of algae. Now the second type is heterogametes. Heterogametes, when gametes are morphologically distinct. For example, human being. If you take the example of human being produce two types of gametes, male gamete and female gamete, and they both gametes are different in shape and size. That is why they are called heterogametes. In lower organisms, male and female gamete are named in different way. For example, male gamete is called anthrozoid, and female gamete is called egg. Now here the new term, bisexual organism. What are the bisexual organism? Bisexual organisms are those organisms which bears both male and female reproductive structure in same body. The term homothallic and monoecious are also used to denote the bisexual condition. It means, if we say homothallic organism, monoecious organism, then also you should understand they are the bisexual organisms. Here you can see the example of bisexual organisms. Hibiscus, mustard, brinjal, lily, they all are the examples of bisexual organisms. See here, this is a diagram of hibiscus flower, which bears both male and female sex organs. Male sex organ androecium, female sex organ is gynoecium. That is why it is called bisexual flower. Now come to the next point. Unisexual organisms. Unisexual organisms are those organisms where male and female reproductive structures are separate. For example, human being, birds, reptiles are the example of animals, while papaya, coconut, maize, watermelon are the example of plants. They are the example of unisexual organism because they bear only one sex organ, either male or female. In unisexual plants, if the flower bears only one sex organ, that is stamen, it is called staminate flower. If it bears pistil, it is called pistillate flower. Now come to the next point, cell division during gamete formation. Children, this you know very well. When the gametes are produced, they are produced by cell division, either by mitosis or by meiosis. So here you should know in which case mitosis occur, in which case meiosis occur. See, if the parent body would be haploid, then definitely mitosis will occur and the haploid gametes are produced, because already the parent body is haploid. If meiosis will occur here, then how the haploid gametes will be produced? Okay, so because already parent body is haploid, that's why parent body undergo the mitosis and produce the haploid gametes. But in case of diploid parent body, when the gametes will produce, then the body will undergo the meiosis and the haploid gametes will produce. Okay, because here the meiosis will occur to make the chromosome number half in the gametes. Now the next important term is meiosites. Meiosites are the special cells which undergo meiosis to form the gametes. Meiosites are diploid cells. See here, I have given few examples of organisms like human beings, housefly, dog, apple. Their meiosites consist of, like if you take the example of human being, meiosites consist of 46 number of chromosome and gamete consists of 23 number of chromosome. Similarly, if you take the example of housefly, housefly meiosites consist of 12 number of chromosome and gametes half, that is 6. Dog's meiosites consist of 78 number of chromosome and gametes half, that is 39. Last, apple, which consists of 34 in case of meiosites, and in case of gametes it is half. This I can explain you with the help of this diagram. You can see here, this is the human sperm cell or human egg cell. These are the meiosites which are diploid. They consist of 2 and number. When they go for the fertilization, first they form the haploid gametes by undergoing the meiosis cell division and produce the haploid gametes. You can see here, when the meiosis occurs, the sperm divides into two and form the haploid gametes. Similarly, the egg also undergo the meiosis and produce the haploid gametes. So here we can say that always gametes have half number of chromosome of meiosites. Meiosites are diploid cells while gametes are haploid cells. Thank you. This is all for today.